think they would have, a safety pin. I guess now they might look for hand lotion, something bizarre. And you see the person scrambling through their thing, looking and hoping that maybe they were prepared for Monty Hall's last crazy question. And did you ever go and say, what in the world, why did they have a pencil sharpener, or whatever the goofy thing was, on their person? It was almost as if they came to this game show prepared for anything. And another part of me says, I could almost hear my grandmother saying, why, when you ask her, why did you bring that? Well, you just never know. You might need this. Maybe some of you still say this. I don't know. But there is that part of us that we all know that when we leave our house each day, we ought to be prepared for what's coming down the pipe. Maybe make sure we got some money, a little spare change, whatever it is we might need, because you just don't know what might happen. And it sure would stink to not have what you needed at that particular moment. Most of us are pretty good about getting what we're sure we need, but how many of you have left your house going, I know I'm forgetting something, and then someday we're down the trip that day is when it's gonna dawn on you exactly what it was that you should have had. Or in a more unfortunate circumstance, you've left for Europe and now determined that you have forgotten something that was really important to the trip. All of us, the notion of being prepared. As a Boy Scout, I recall that that is the Scout motto, to be prepared. And for the most part, I think I generally leave the house prepared. Yesterday being an exception when I went to ShopRite and forgot eggs, I bet I didn't get that far before I realized it. But in today's gospel, Jesus tells us about 10 bridesmaids. Not literal bridesmaids, but just a parable to get a point across. 5 of them foolish, 5 wise. The foolish ones obviously brought lamps. That's a good thing. You're told to have a lamp. Make sure there was oil in said lamp. Good idea, too. Sort of like making sure there's gas in the car before you leave on the trip. But what they didn't bring was enough oil extra just in case the guy didn't show up in time. And that's always possible, isn't it? That the expected time is not always the exact time. And we understand that this was not just a 10-minute delay, it was quite a delay. A delay to which they just basically fell asleep. And suddenly they're warned, he's here, get ready. And they turn on the lamp and or get it a little brighter, and all of a sudden you realize you're almost out. I don't blame the wise ones for saying, no way, Jose. There's no way I'm sharing this with you. I only have enough for me. Not my problem that you didn't think ahead of time what you might need. And go get your own, folks. Go see if there's a 24/7 Walgreens. Whatever it is you need to go, fine. Go get this oil. And of course, the bridegroom comes while they're away. The doors get shut. And when they finally come back triumphant with their purchase, find the door not so readily open, and being told these horrible words, I do not know you. There is actually the main point of the gospel, isn't it? It's not so much about being a good bridesmaid as much as it's about, are you truly prepared? Are you really ready? I mean, this seems more of an Advent theme than a Pentecost theme. But all of us in our day-to-day lives should be asking that question. Are we really prepared? For today was the day that Jesus came walking through that door. Are we ready? Doesn't mean making sure we got our bags packed fully and all the extras we could think of. As much of are our lives showing that we expected Jesus any minute. Even if it's been 2,100 years since somebody wrote these words, and decided that we should be ready because it's imminent. I'm not going to be one of those preachers who tells you he's coming tomorrow, because that's not what the Bible tells us. The Bible tells us you don't get to know that date, but you still need to be prepared, to be ready. And preparation for us as Christians to be starts, of course, with our prayer life. Is it where we should be? Are we, if God loves us, warts and all, as my father always used to put it, are we keeping our side of the bargain as well? It's all well and good that God loves me, knows everything I'm doing, but if I never bother to communicate with God, to check in from time to time, say, this is how it's going for me, I think I'm doing what you would have me do this today, we might get caught unawares. Our preparation ought to be seen in the actions we do, the way we live our lives, how we treat other people. Are we doing the things that we would long to hear at the end of our lives? These words, well done, good and faithful servant, which is also in Matthew, as compared to today's words, I do not know you. The way we will be looked at as Christians is by those actions, by our preparation and the way we have nurtured and strengthened our relationship with God. If we wait, the reason I think we're never told what day it's coming is because God knows most of us would wait until the last possible moment to start getting our acts together. And instead invites us not to be paranoid about it, but to just be faithful about it, to live our lives as if we don't want to be caught being foolish. We want to be caught being wise. We want to be ready whenever that bridegroom comes, or whether it's just that our earthly pilgrimage has ended and we're now longing to be with the Lord. So I would ask you to consider this week. How are you prepared? Do you feel prepared at all? Not just for the manic season that's coming at us like a freight train, but more about your day-to-day lives living as Christians in the 21st century. When you walk out these doors, do you feel strengthened and encouraged to do whatever it is God has given you to do this day and the week to come? When we have prepared, we may feel like we've overpacked sometimes, but I think I'd rather fall to my grandmother's way of looking at it. You just never know. Maybe that extra set of stuff was necessary. If it wasn't, oh well, couldn't have weighed that much anyway. But to the main point, to be prepared, whether you're a Boy Scout or not, is the ultimate way of living life. To go as if, things will just take care of themselves, maybe good from time to time, but can be a little frightening. And in fact, you might be caught unaware. Amen.